on Gibraltar. Right now, if our water team is able to sweep, they will be in the finals.
This is real. This is live. Yeah.
If water's able to sweep, they will be in the finals. Let me make sure things are set up correctly, which they are. All right. So, we will be having an opportunity to see Xav play again here. He's going to be subbing in for one of our other players. Get an opportunity to see what he can do to kind of help our win team win it all. Or I guess our water team, rather. So if you like underdogs, you definitely want to be looking and watching our water team. There are current underdog players. They've only got one win under their belt here, but the way the standings are set up right now, that one is enough to win. That being said, they're up against a really tough team here. We've seen these guys consistently shred team after team, but they do have their hot and cold moments. Definitely team win led primarily by Dan on DPS with his Soldier and Tracer, but they've got some strong support off SJ the Ripper as well as Narraziri just for some good tank play there. That duo has done a really good job holding that front line while Howl and Broswagonus take up the back. We'll say we've seen Broswagonus a lot more on Roadhog, so it'll be interesting to see what his healer play is able to do. Runaway Jess, we don't really see him on Winston too much. This is going to be interesting. They're doing kind of a weird divey move here, and we're going to see if it pays off. Right out the gate, holding on to the point. And they're going to see what water team's able to do here. SJ Ripper and Narazimi holding the front. Dan getting some early picks here, holding them off. That Winston didn't work out for him too well. And Dan's just up there picking him off. Ooh, Dan's in a really strong position. Xav's caught him, though. Nice job picking up those healers. So even though we got water team trying to damage them and get in there, they're still pushing right through, which is probably not where you want to be. So we've got our team water just continually pushing through, doing a really good job of that, chasing them down. And Tremulous, really worried making this D.Va work with the assistance of Xav. We got Mortius Mort respawning as our McCree. Here we got Runaway Jess trying to make something happen, making some space with this Winston. Looks like this is going to be uncontested, almost, unless that Ryan moves in, which he doesn't. Runaway Jess holding the high ground here, looking for his opportunity. Falls down, drops his shield. Just holding in. Ooh, getting picked apart real quick before any heals can get to him. Xav falling asleep. Nope. Ooh, great ult. Recognizes that Dan's a threat. They didn't know what caught him. Xav just running him down. Doing a really good job here of moving through the point. We got Tremulous with the D.Va ult up. So we're seeing the water team who needs to sweep this if they're going to be able to make it through is really making it happen. An opportunity to pause it. Oh, just does not work out for them. Xav continually raining death from above. Narazimi all out there by himself, just a matter of time. Wow. Water is rolling right through them here. It looks like they really want to be in the finals here, and they could make it happen. Dan isn't going to let it happen, though. Ooh, getting a lot of picks there. Dropping down. Looks like Wind Team is going to be able to hold this here. Ooh, D.Va all trying to contest. Wow, really good hold by Water Team here. They were not able to really just... I'm sorry, good hold by the Wind Team there. Water Team was not able to finish it off, but... Again and again, just raining down some big hits there. And they're slowly starting to collapse. Good pickup. Oh, man. Dang. Howl, though, might be able to breathe some extra life into this team here. He's going to pop that res, and he's going to do it. Keeping the team up. We got Mortius coming in with a Deadeye. He knows if he can get that diva out of Mech, he'll be in good shape, but Xavier getting nasty. Chasing down that Anna, but even with her nerf damage, still able to make it happen. Sentren really wants to make this point happen, but it's just not going to be there. They managed to get the kill there. And they've stabilized on the point. Oh my. Wynn unexpectedly able to hold that point. Dan's already got his ult back up again, taking that high ground. And they got the Deadeye as well. Really need to work on that D.Va. You can see Xavier kind of above the point, trying to get some pickoffs there, but great teamwork there, taking him out. Dan getting supported pretty heavily by Howl there, which I think is going to be pretty influential as we move up. Ooh, the Boostio, not what you want to see. They get a big ult there. That's not going to be good. Pops his ult a little early to just guarantee the Winston kill, and big mistake for our Anna player there. Lynx probably was not expecting that ult, and they're looking at another push here, but they still got 2 minutes, so a lot of time here. Dan's still holding his ult. That D.Va's going to cause some issues, though, for him if he thinks he'll be able to get that off. All right, Tremulous trying to make something happen here. Starts tracking that Pharah for some reason. Ooh, great moves by Runaway just there, picking off the healer from behind. Looks like Wynn team isn't able to make anything happen there. They're all starting to trickle in here. Our healers are down. We should see the water team cap this point and make a run for the end here. Nice plays by Xavier to extend that time. All right, so we're on to the final point here. Xavier's doing a really good job boosting forward, trying to chase it down. Wasn't able to catch anybody out. He's starting to wrap around there. He knows his ult's coming up soon. He's going to try and make something happen here. Dan, though, sees him. Mortius not able to make those hits as he drops back down. Astray Ripper trying to make it happen. Isn't able to connect there. We've got Howl with his ult. Oh, wasn't able to get it off as Xavier comes up from behind. Really picks up some big kills there. And that's going to really open the path here for Water to push right around that bend. Typically the hardest part to get through there. Early ult by Link. I don't know if I necessarily agree with that, but at this point, they're just trying to push it in all the way. Ooh, Bro Swaggin is trying to keep it up a little bit longer. We've got Howl's ult.
All right, looks like I missed a lot here.
We got a big opportunity. SJ Ripper trying to hold the point, but they don't have anybody to contest, and that's it. Water team runs it in. The minute and a half left.
Wow. Just talking to a fellow competitor there on some feedback for the league. Got some good info.
What was the info?
Well, we're talking about season duration, like how long do we want the seasons to last, and how that maybe once, maybe more times a week. Maybe we want to go to, twice a week league play because he felt that there was too much time in between each, the match play. So that was kind of a point of contention, so we're talking about that as well. But we'll see. Obviously, we're going to get a feedback from all our players this season, and then we'll see how quickly we can turn it around into the next.
We should also do a Twitch fan of the league.
Oh, yeah.
Honestly, I don't know about you. On the count of three, let's both say who we think should get, Twitch fan of the season. All right?
Yeah,
One, two, three, Risky. Lorik.
Oh.
What?
Who?
That guy just showed up.
Oh, who's that?
Risky's been here every single time.
Oh.
How are you? Oh
I was just looking at who was chatting it up there.
No.
Was geez. Risky the one? Was he the one who was there last week giving
Everybody loves Dan.
I don't. Everybody loves Dan.
He's a lovable guy.
Yeah. He is. Oh, now he's pulling out the Widow.
Yeah, all right. So we got Dan with the Widow, Golden Gun. Yeah. Really good move, kind of getting out of the gate here. We're going to see what he's going to be able to do.
All right.
It's cool. I like it. Morty is switching off the McCree. Going Genji. We've seen him be Genji before.
So
seen it work out well.
I was going to say, if you're going to sum up that last match, what were our big defining forces on water there? Who are we looking out for right now?
Just Xav shutting down. Shutting down the other team. Just outmaneuvering them, getting behind them, doing a great job of just really good positioning, really good alts there. Even despite one Boostio, which really screwed them for a little bit, but they made it happen. Right, here's Dan.
Looks like that's my favorite vantage point for that for that damage. Up in that corner there, that's where
Oh,
my.
Danzo not giving up. He's trying to make this work.
Right, I thought Golden Gun was a one-shot kill. Is that not working this game?
It might be. So this is the issue, though. Al, he's been up there trying to work on it. Well, I guess it's been working. The whole team is just completely falling back from the water team, which is good. Picking up those healers.
Oh, Tremulous.
Oof. But just as we say that, Dan picks up a kill on his own and making something happen. Tremulous has had a great game here. He's been one of the consistent water players that's just continually showing up, doing damage, doing a good job.
I love those aggressive D.Va players because it shuts down that back line.
Absolutely. He's done a really good job, even last game, picking up Howl and making his life hell, more or less. Now he's trying to reach around here.
Oh, Genji. Nice Mortius ball. Mort. Nice move.
But it's not going to... great support from SJ Ripper there.
Yeah.
And he's keeping
his SJ is hanging on by a thread.
Needs his healers here. Where are you at? You're not there. But he's able to stay up. They're not targeting
him. That's amazing.
He's able to keep Mortius up. This is really scary for SJ Ripper here.
It is.
Runaway just needs to be swinging that hammer. Narazini comes in, saves SJ Ripper, and they're on to that point.
There they go. Well, Wind is picking it up very well. I mean, that... I guess they couldn't have lost that bad.
No, absolutely. You know, you notice SJ Ripper and Narazuri, I know for sure, play together a lot, and it really shows in their coordination together at that front line. Having a front line that works together like that makes a big difference, and it shows. They trust each other, they know when to go in, and it's awesome. You notice that great shield on his buddy there, and they just are tearing apart this enemy Rhine.
Oh, wow.
Just allows them to move forward.
SJ Ripper's doing a great job at shutting down these tanks.
Absolutely. They got some good support. They've got a nice little core team here that's not getting touched.
Oh, wait. I thought Zarya was supposed to... Well, no, that's not true.
Here we go.
Boy.
Big ult coming down, and it somehow misses everyone.
How is that
Tremulous
possible?
Has got to be wondering what's going on, and Dan is just in the back sniping away.
As soon as he saw that D.Va jump out of mech, bam. He's sitting there back. Now we got the vision.
He's waiting.
Waiting for that
down. So good move by Sentren there. Recognizes that, you know, Dan's again a strong player. And if he's able to get on him as Winston, he can really shut him down and make that Widow less effective. The issue though being you still need to be able to take care of the rest of your team. Narazuri comes in. Great plays there.
Whoa.
Big ults coming down here.
Wow, that was huge by Zave. Again, surprised with the Pharah ult there. Very effective.
So Mortius saves his ult on that, even though I thought I saw it activated.
Yeah.
But wasn't enough to trigger it. And they're kind of pulling back a little bit here to regroup, figure out what they're going to do next.
Zarya's still got a little bit of charge here, SJ Ripper. Again, Monkey just... Yeah, get Zarya out there. Charge that shield up. Yep.
Got to be careful here, though. He's got his ult, but that D.Va can eat it and make your life very painful. But they're going to probably be trying to combo that Genji ult with Zarya here.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it'll be to a lot of success. There's your opportunity.
There we go.
Pulls it in. But you know what? Oh, they don't have a Mercy. Never mind.
Oh, no. Wow. Well played, Ripper. Well played.
Nope. Xav stops it from happening. But you know what? Might not be enough here. If Dan is able to...
Well, what's Dan? Where's Dan? Oh.
Dan is up top there, getting picked apart, though.
Ooh.
Oh. Tries to push it.
Xav said no.
So this is tough. They're making a lot of back-and-forth plays. This happened to to Team Water last time. They were able to push through it with some great alts and good coordination. I don't know if we're going to see it again. Howl, though, getting dived quickly by this Winston, and there's no one there to help him.
Howl cannot get out of there.
Really smart moves, though, by Sentry, and he's going to be able to live through this, no problem, and he's still got his ult on.
Yep.
You know, Sentry's a player we haven't talked too much about, honestly.
No.
He's another one of those, like Tremulous, that's just a consistent player who's able to really respond to what the other enemy team is doing. Look at him taking Dan out, getting back in there.
Oh.
Ooh, but Howl pops a big res there.
Yeah.
Ooh, that D-Vault might be hurting. It does. Picks up two.
And Zave cleaning up the rest as well.
Yep. Mortius able to get a quick pick there, but isn't going to be able to make anything happen. He's going to start to back out.
Can we also just point out the Tony Hawk soundtrack just began playing at Ignite here.
I think that Swift Strike would be enough to kill
him. Yes, there it is enough. Pick. What a nice reach. That was like you could see the future there.
Right, you know. Play enough of this game and it feels like it sometimes.
Yeah.
There we go. Big ult. They're coming in. Fab's the only one on the other team with his ult. The question is, who's he going to use it on? He's thinking the D.Va, maybe.
Maybe.
Oh, gets eaten by the shield,
D.Va?
Sort of.
Get in
there it is. This is what they were waiting for.
Yeah.
Dan, though, cleaning up. Going to pop that ult. There it is. Dan's easily going to pick this off, and they should be able to get this point. I'd be shocked if they didn't. And there we go. All right. So we got a run here at the point. They're already running behind, though, the other team. But
wow.
The nice thing about this point is, or I guess the Knights team, if your team wind, is all you need to do is get the point.
Yeah.
Narazumi comes in, tries to make some stuff happen, but that ult might have just been a little bit too aggressive for his team. He didn't have the follow-up he needed. Xave consistently doing a good job of this. Ooh, SJ Ripper, not enough.
Ooh, and the punch to the face is the final blow.
Team starting to split apart, and the other team is just completely taking advantage of that.
Yeah, Wind got they just spread out, and then now, hopefully this isn't it for them, but
they need to regroup, recenter, and then make a concerted push. Link, though, is going to be able to prevent really anything significant from pushing in with this ult if he's able to time it right. Doesn't want to do it too early, doesn't want to do it too late.
So here comes this. This is maybe the last push unless they go to... Oh! Well,
Dan,
they knocked out
down.
Dan there. That's their main DPS. That's going to hurt.
They're probably going to want to regroup here, but... Ooh, you're going to need to...
Yeah.
This is an uncomfortable position. They're picking them one by one. So,
yeah.
And now with the Mercy down, I just don't see this being able to happen.
Yeah.
Dan, though, is able to make... To connect it.
Dan made it back.
He's back there, and
he is cleaning up house there. Whoa.
We've got this Howl alt up there. They got to get on that
get
point.
Get up there. Get up there.
Three-man raise. Big res there with the alt. Coming down from
Broswagonist.
He's going to keep him in.
Yes.
Mortius Mord cleaning up just like that. He's going to have his alt again real quick, which is going to make it real tough, and they're going to have an opportunity here. Got to get in there for the dash.
Oh, my.
Dash
again.
Bash and forth. They're looking at potentially... getting this whole point.
Wow. So I think Dan's fan club is probably really excited right now.
There we go.
That was a game
big
changer.
Alt.
Wow. Huge alt with Mortius Mort here. Just
Link's
relentless.
Able to get his alt down, but now we're in those final minutes here, and it's just not looking good.
Seconds.
Final meters. Holy man.
Wow.
Wind pulls it out at the last minute with an unbelievable rest from Howl.
Wow.
Keeping him in the game.
Howl and Dan, that's the way to do it. Jeez.
Great plays there. Just
and
everything
Mort,
coming
that
together.
Whole team.
Yep.
Each role so crucial in that. If one of those didn't succeed, they would not be looking at a win there. Wow, that was impressive.
That was an entire team
that was
effort
my
there.
That was my favorite push tonight so far. That was really enjoyable.
That was legitimately an entire full team success there. We had the great Zarya ult there at the end, Dan opening up the opportunity, Howl coming in with a three-man res, keeping everybody up there, followed up immediately by a Broswagonist sound barrier, which kept everybody up, and they just ran them right down.
Yeah.
You gotta wonder, you know, they're...
That's a very and also the you also notice the experienced Mercy player is really using the environment for cover. And I know that sounds painfully obvious, but if you watch a Mercy player like that and then you watch a Mercy player like me, it's pretty evident who's actually playing Mercy and who doesn't. Because the only reason that Rez worked was exactly the route that she took to get to the group to Rez him was perfect.
Absolutely. You know, at those moments, I want to, like, smash cut to gameplay of you, like, just, like, walking off a cliff as Mercy and be like, that's not...
Getting bopped off.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, oh, there you go. All right, so Dan, picking up a Roadhog. Haven't seen this yet from him, but I'm sure he's thinking, let's get some quick...
Boom. Oh, no.
Oh, let's get some quick picks, make something happen, which is really going to mess him up here.
Yeah.
Sentryn went Winston, probably anticipating another Widow or something like that.
Well, you can see what they're thinking. I mean...
Mortius opting for the Soldier, which is interesting because he did really well as Genji.
It was,
and it's...
It was pretty good. It's surprising that he's going to switch off, but somebody had to take another DPS role in there.
So here they are trying to push through. SJ Ripper goes down first, which is not good
so
for them.
So water, are they split up again here? I'm trying to see where all the positions are.
Well, we've got some up top, some on bottom. They got 10 seconds left.
Still okay.
This really comes down to, is Howl going to be able to get this alt up? And he's not. And that's going to be it for the point, I think. Might be able to have Dan hold on a little bit longer, but
no.
That's just going to run out of time there.
Yeah. We moved it a good distance, but we'll see here.
2.5 minutes. The only way I think that Wind is going to be able to pull this off is with some special tactics. Special tactics, Symmetra, Bastions, something. We've seen Dan play Bastion to some success.
This would be a time to pull out Orisa and see what happens.
That's, I agree. Now is
you've got an extra shield drop on that payload.
Absolutely. Something's... Yep, there's Dan with the Bastion, and Howl's a good Mercy, so that's a good combo.
All right.
I mean, it's doable. We know it's doable. And SJ Ripper with the May. They're looking at just delaying the point. This all kind of comes down to this right here.
I'm surprised that they're running a Lucio and Mercy, considering what they're trying to do here.
So if water is able to win this, they're going to be on their way to I think still being in the tournament. I think water needs to sweep if they want to stay. Yeah. So if water is able to win this, they could be on their way to being in the tournament. They're being in the finals rather.
Mm-hmm.
So it's an exciting opportunity for them. I think Zave coming out, but where's our boy Dan at? All right, holding the corner here. They got the May out there. Xavier, though, is going to give him
right
hell.
Into it.
Oh, trying to res up. There we go. That's
Dan
good. They're not going to be able to
that
do
was
it.
Good.
Tremulous burns his whole defense matrix, trying to hold it down. This is going to hurt if that defense matrix goes down. Is he going to get slept up here, though? He's not.
Maybe. No.
He's
kind of
cut him off a little bit. He's going to try and come in behind him. Oh, falls off the payload. But he just shreds him. Somebody's got to keep him up, though. Howl isn't able to keep him up, but we'll see if it's enough damage here. Or if they've got enough on the point here to make it stick around.
That was pretty impressive.
Oh, that was very good.
Very
got a big
Bastion.
Move here, though.
Yeah.
Dan's already got his ult up. They're going to have an opportunity potentially here at the point. Howl knows he's got to stay back. He's got to be able to get this res off.
Howl's like, if we have any prayer, got to stay back to that Bastion.
But Dan's coming
right
in with
the
save there. They're down to a minute. SJ Ripper picks off the heels. Really successful. Howl's looking at, might have his ult up. Ooh, but he gets taken out. They got the reinforcements, though, coming in here. We're going to see if this can do anything. Ooh, alt into the Winston shield. That's not going to hit anybody.
Did not work.
And they're in real tough shape here. Howl needs to make it back
A
here.
For effort. A for effort on that. They were in their head was in the right mind.
Big alt there. Things are just coming apart. Mortius able to stick it around.
Hide behind that payload.
Here we go. Could this be another big alt? It is.
And it is. Howl. Wow.
Ooh, wasn't able to get her shift down. Got Dan really getting work done here. He's trying to stick it around here. Yeah. He's trying to heal through it.
No, not enough heals there. Not enough self-healing. No,
Link is going to pop the res here. For Swagnus, though, on the point, this is going to be enough potentially to hold it. We just need SJ Ripper on there too far.
No. 3-4 water.
All right. Water manages to pull off a win here. So they're on the track right now. If Water is able to sweep them, which they're on the track to, they will be in the top spot, which looks like what they're going for. Who's our play of the game to Xave? Good plays. Definitely worthy of this win here. This is going to be the one at the end.
Oh, yeah. Well timed.
Great plays there. Great plays.
Wow.